Yeah, I seriously contemplated pitting there to get us out of that shitstorm of shit. They're not done wrecking enough of them yet.
That was a good, like, calm, low-key, upset moment.
Calm, Kurt.
Yeah. But like, still a shitstorm of shit.
Yeah, like he clarified that the shitstorm
is of
was
shit.
Made of
yeah,
shit.
Yeah. What else would be in that storm?
I don't know.
Would there be some urine?
I don't know. We had a weird discussion about this earlier, so I don't know if I want to continue our
discussion about bodily items.
But
not just fluids.
Yeah.
Anyways.
Yeah.
So
welcome to the Glass Case of Motion.
I was thinking back what we were talking about. But yeah, we're back in our normal studio.
Yeah.
It's not as
hot.
I'm gonna be honest with you. It's not as nice as what we had last week.
It isn't.
Or
last week
the
was
week
nice.
Before. Like 2 weeks in a row we've
yeah.
done
yeah.
We were in a bus.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right.
Then we were grilling.
Outside, yeah.
yeah.
And now
we're in a studio.
We're back here.
But
so
we have some lovely Tennessee apple butter that we can like sniff and remind us
and
of what
magic.
The grilling.
I will say I was like. pretty happy with our grilling.
Oh, that is pungent.
Well,
it's
what did
the,
you expect?
Design on the pants.
Yes.
We'll take them back to the pants store.
Smells like Bigfoot.
Smells like Tennessee apple butter.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was pretty good, man. I enjoyed it. I didn't take any of these home with me. I should have, but
well, that's what they're here for.
I think they're here now for you.
You can take, but you're going somewhere straight here from here, so you can't take them.
I went
home.
To Terre Haute.
Terre Haute. What's in Terre Haute?
Where is Terre Haute?
There is a brand new Menards opening in Terre Haute.
Oh, you get to like cut the ribbon.
No, it's been open probably for like a week, but it's like the grand opening now.
Ooh.
So we're doing a little signing. It's not a grand opening. It's been open for a week, but we're going there to do a signing.
So there was a soft open, and now it's like the big party open.
Now it's the hard open.
Yeah. I don't even think it's like a hard open. I think it's just like open. Mm. It's been open for a little bit, and we're just going to sign autographs to kind of draw people in, I guess.
Flaccid.
We do that every now and then.
Yeah.
Flaccid open.
Where's Terre Haute?
Indiana.
No, but like what part of Indiana? Yeah, where's it near?
It's in the state. I don't know.
Is it near Gary, Indiana?
I don't know.
Gary.
Not Louisiana, Paris, France, New York, or Rome.
I don't know what song you're referring
to. Gary, Indiana. Gary, Indiana.
What song
Gary,
is
Indiana.
That?
My home, sweet home. It's from The Music Man.
Oh.
Yeah.
I have no idea.
Yeah.
All I know is Terre Haute has a good dirt track over there.
Ooh, yeah. A little dirt tracking.
Mm-hmm.
Terre Haute?
That could be a name. A girl's name is
Terre
Haute.
It's Terre Haute.
Is a hoe.
Is Terre a hoe? Tune in next week to find out.
Tara's going to be on the show.
Yeah, she is. You know, special guest, Terre Haute.
Speaking of Menards.
Yeah, speaking of Menards, we were looking for that little transition.
Big reveal.
Uh-huh.
Thought you actually were coming in to be supportive of Matt DiBenedetto.
I am.
No,
I'm supportive of Paul.
Paul's retiring.
Yeah.
Paul is retiring.
Yeah.
But sliding into the...
Okay, he's not retiring. He is retiring from full-time racing.
Full-time.
Right. I think he's still going to do a little bit more.
Yeah.
But he's retiring from full-time racing. I think he still wants to race, but what and where and when, that...
Remains a mystery.
...is the question.
Which is suitable because Paul is a mystery.
Yeah, he's building a mystery.
Yeah.
Building a mystery.
Sorry, you're all about singing today.
It's song titled that.
No, yeah, so that was,
what'd
that was
you,
some
think?
Big news.
What'd you think? Did you know, first of all?
I knew about it for a few days.
Okay.
Beforehand. They did a good job of keeping it secret.
They did.
You know, all these things kind of break out somehow, and I think they did a good job of keeping it really tight. And
they were pretty tight-lipped.
Mm-hmm. And so that was good. You never get announcements like that nowadays that are like no one ever leaks it from a source. I've always wondered, where do reporters get their sources from? Like,
we had Matt on here and he didn't weeks ago.
I don't think he knew about it then.
Even at that point, that wasn't even that long ago. Did this happen fast?
A couple weeks ago. Things happen fast in NASCAR.
Yeah.
Wow.
NASCAR world. Yeah.
So. Sources are interesting.
Yeah, they're snitches is what they are.
And snitches, you know what snitches
get? Stitches.
Yeah, they get stitches. We
How
used
many?
To have a snitch. We used to have our NASCAR. I have a pretty good idea who our snitch was, but we used to have NASCAR meetings.
Yeah.
Like, you know, NASCAR and drivers would have these big meetings. We'd talk about all sorts of things, rules and
secret
schedules
things.
And secrets. And like 30 minutes later, someone would have a story about what we just talked
about. I was just
about
to ask you what drivers you thought were... Not that you're going to tell us, but you think there's some drivers that are...
I think there are. There's drivers,
have loose lips?
Oh, yeah.
You know what they say about loose lips?
Yeah.
They sink ships.
They do.
Yeah, and they only dance for tips.
This is true.
Ooh.
But their hips don't lie.
Is this Shakira?
And a lot of them have
quirky
nips.
I don't really know.
All the ips we could do.
Yeah.
But I mean, when I dip, you dip, we dip.
I'm going to just stop it right there, Chuck.
So, yeah. I was really trying to think of something else to say, but I don't know.
Snitches. Getting stitches and such. And
I know. I feel like I think it's one or two drivers that used to snitch. I don't think those drivers are part of those meetings anymore. I think we weeded them out. But
you send some false information out there.
Yeah.
Try and find
That's
the source of the leak.
What, yeah.
Yeah.
The mole.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. What kind of... Here's my thing. If you're a driver that's a snitch, what are you getting from that? Are you getting better coverage from the source that's you're snitching to? Are you getting... Obviously, I wouldn't think it's monetary.
I've always wanted
like,
to know
that.
Like,
what are you gaining?
Yeah, I mean, like any kind of...
You just feel powerful?
...source or snitch. Like, I mean, when all the Antonio Brown stuff was coming out, like, all these sources had stuff. Like, all these people... I'm like, what is that source getting in return? Like, are they getting paid by that person, you know, to... Give them information?
Depends.
I don't know.
I mean, it depends on where the outlet is, what the outlet is. Is it a freelance guy? Then, yeah, they're getting...
I had a theory that the outlet who the reporter is working for gives them a budget per year to go out and finance these sources to give them information.
Yeah.
That's my theory.
Collusion, huh?
But, collusion.
Yeah, suffocation.
What would a driver gain?
No breathing.
Don't give
a roach.
Yeah. Cut my arm.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know, man. But yeah, we had some snitches in there. But yeah, it was a good job of not leaking it. But I'm happy for Matt.
Matty D.
I think he's a good fit for that group.
Yeah,
I was texting with him a little bit this morning. There's the guy who copies our show, Corey LaJoy. He can't hear what I'm saying.
Plastic box of feelings.
I'm happy for him. And Paul still has 10 races to go. So
Paulie,
in this year, so I think he'll be good.
Paul Menard.
Yeah, but I think he wants to spend more time with his family and.
Yeah, he's got 100%. Two of them.
All that stuff.
Makes
so,
sense.
Hey, man.
Yeah. Can't blame him. He's been around for a long time.
Yeah.
I mean, people forget how long he's been around.
It
I was
has
looking
been
back
a while.
At his win at the Brickyard.
11.
The Brickyard. And,
like, that's been a minute. Like,
it's been 8 years.
And, like, to me, that's crazy that that was that long ago.
That,
I remember,
when
like,
when
it was
I saw
yesterday.
The date, I was kind of like, whoa.
Yeah.
Yeah. I remember watching that race.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's crazy, dude.
Time flies when you're having fun.
Yeah. Time flies.
Yeah. Like, I think Monday of this week was my 9-year anniversary of working for the NASCARs.
I've been in the sport almost 10 years, I think.
Yeah.
10 years.
Yeah.
10 years.
She's got tenure.
I think. Nine
is
or
that
ten.
What
nine
that
or
is?
Ten.
Like when college professors have tenure?
Tenure. And it's not that it's not that you're there for 10 years.
Okay, I was about to say, that's kind of a short amount of time of like not being able to get fired.
You get tenured.
You get tenured.
Yeah.
Which means you can kind of...
Do whatever you want.
Go
walk around naked if you want to. It's like, I'm tenured. I can just walk around naked and talk about Bigfoot sightings all I want to. Yeah.
Like, that's going to be the coolest gig ever.
Yeah.
To be a college professor and get tenured. To where you can pretty much do whatever you want.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to write my thesis on using Tennessee apple butter as bath salt. I bathe myself in Pit Boss rubs.
What would...
Does it smell like fresh smoked meat?
I have to pay you to... Wash yourself with this as like a body scrub.
I don't know if you would like have to pay.
You
me
would want to smell like the Tennessee apple butter.
I'd be interested in seeing like what would people think.
I
like,
think it would exfoliate too.
Like,
do you
take
think
a shower
the
and
women
rub it.
Would flock to you?
I don't know.
Maybe. I mean, like the hickory bacon. I don't know.
Well, that might.
Maybe. The mango, but see, mango magic.
You might end up with a, you know, like.
Vegans wouldn't like you. That's
no,
for sure.
No. You're not going to get a vegan.
No vegans.
But
sorry.
I don't know. Maybe with the mango magic, you might get a vegan with mango magic.
You might.
Lime's a vegetable.
Yeah. Lime's a vegetable.
At the table.
No, lime's a fruit.
Yes, you wouldn't.
Is lime a fruit? Yeah, lime's a fruit.
Would a vegan, you could use vegetables though. Yeah. I was going to say, would a vegan support this since it's technically to marinate meat, but you can marinate vegetables.
You can
in
marinate
it too.
Vegetables like.
Marinate anything.
I would be interested though to see what would happen if you
bathed
in that.
It smells delightful.
Can I smell the mango magic?
That ain't bad, man. I don't know. The hickory bacon didn't smell too good.
No.
The sancho lime.
It still smells
I don't
meaty,
think they
though.
Smell great like when you're just like sitting there sniffing them. But when they're rubbed on that meat.
I got some in my nose.
When you're rubbing it on the meat.
No, yeah. I think the ladies would come flocking with the mango magic. Personally.
We should do that. That's going to be a social experiment.
Would you put it in like a hinge bio? It's like, I bathe myself in mango magic.
Maybe.
It's like, I piss excellence in the morning.
Yeah. I think I would leave that a secret and then show up and just see if they like it or not. And just, that's kind of the person they are. What if you'd be like soulmate if they were like, Is that Mango Magic?
Is that Pit Boss Mango Magic?
Yes, it is. Yes, yeah. As a matter of fact, I have a ring with me right now.
Will you? Yes, will you? I will. That would be an interesting video to like do one of those like hidden camera type things where you show up to a date.
After you
like,
bathe yourself in meat rub. Yeah.
Like how long would that date last?
I think you would have to bathe yourself and you would have to let... Like, you would have to instill some, like, water or oil with this so you could spray it on yourself to really...
Oh, like a little spritz.
Yeah, like to infuse.
Or you could, bathe yourself with it, wash it off, and then just put, like, some in your pockets.
Like a little satchel.
So it's still there.
A little cachet.
Yeah, or like a necklace that it kind of, like, the aroma exfoliates out of that necklace.
Do any have garlic? That would keep the vampires... This would keep the vampires away.
Mm-hmm. Wait, are vampires real now?
Maybe. They are real.
Okay. They are.
There's the other host of
which one?
The knockoff podcast show.
Dermot?
The girl. Oh, they actually have four members
the
now.
The girl.
Because Lauren had a baby, and she had the baby in the
studio. I know, the baby was there.
That shit is crazy.
What's the baby's name?
Who's going to have it? You guys can have a baby and bring it in.
There's the kid right there.
There's a baby.
That's like a brand new kid.
It looks like a doll. Bring her in.
That's a baby.
Her name's
Poppy.
Poppy.
She looks like a little baby doll.
Little Poppy seed.
Little Poppy.
Baby is like 2 days old.
Oh, no. I want to see her. She's making all
our podcasts. Oh, here she comes. Here comes the baby onto the pod. We've had dogs. We had
puppies in the studio.
Steaks. And now we're having babies.
Oh, no.
Oh. I'd rather have a baby than a cat.
Yes.
So I'm excited for that.
I would say babies are better than cats.
Bye.
And Kim is now a mom.
Hi.
Put her in my seat, and I'll leave. Yeah. And
does Drew have light eyes? Do you think her eyes are going to stay light?
I don't know. He has blue eyes. I have green eyes.
So we're discussing the eyes of the baby.
Hello. Welcome to the class.
She's looking at you like, I don't like you.
I don't know what's going on. She, oh. Little,
are you going to cry? Don't cry.
See the.
I thought I misheard that. I thought you said she was just breastfeeding on Daryl. Oh, she was. That's. I did hear that correctly.
So did she latch with Daryl? She was trying to latch. Okay. All right.
You're so little.
You were saying that cats.
Get back to your work.
You said babies better than cats?
Thanks for bringing
I'd prefer to have a child on the show than a cat.
Yeah.
You know why?
I got to readjust my seat.
The child will grow up to be a human, a functioning adult.
Yeah.
Whereas the cat is always going to be a damn cat.
What are we debating?
Cats. I'd rather have babies cats on the show than...
Did you say babies are scary?
Babies are scary.
What's scary about a baby?
Oh. It was death staring you.
Death it was staring.
Like, it's trying to steal your soul.
There's nothing in these. Sorry.
Like, these are not producing
what you producing.
Need. These are not
producing. I do think it's funny she tried to breastfeed on Daryl. I don't know what that says about Daryl.
I mean,
you got big old boobies, I guess.
I think there's that Family Guy episode where Peter tries to breastfeed Stewie.
Or the Meet the Fockers, where Robert
nipples,
De Niro
Greg.
Has the...
Can you milk me? Yeah.
I think I'll take the puppy over the baby.
Yeah.
They missed... We didn't bring the puppy on the show today, but...
There's a brand new puppy.
Hannah and Dylan have a new puppy.
We need to get a monkey.
Janet?
That's the dog's name.
That's hilarious.
Janet.
We need to get a monkey so we can have a puppy monkey baby.
What was your debate though about cats or kids?
Cats or kids. So he was saying he'd rather have a kid on the show than a cat.
That is true, 100%.
Yeah, because you'd never see the cat, and then all of a sudden it would like jump on you, and then jump on the counter, and then knock all the shit off the counter, and then you just look at you like, what are you gonna do about it?
And then it would like piss somewhere to just be mean.
Yeah,
there's no sandbox. I'm just gonna spray.
This is mine.
It's like that South Park episode.
Like a nasty hairball.
Yeah. No cats.
No cats.
No cats.
Holy cats, Miss Agnes.
No cats.
Still like them.
You did mention a little bit of the Antonio Brown stuff. Did you follow any of that?
I only followed it because it was on every sports news outlet.
I think my friend actually broke that news.
What?
Really?
Master?
Master.
He was on my...
Master. Master.
He has a new show. He was on my Israel trip.
Metallica show.
Anyway, keep up to speed with what exactly.
Well, no,
happened.
So I watched you ever watched that Hard Knocks show?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's a good show.
Yeah.
They cover the preseason for those of you who don't know, and this year it was the Raiders.
Mm-hmm.
And so they cover like before the first preseason game, and they cover like, they cover like four, it's like four or five episodes.
Yeah.
So I kind of got some of the story on Abe Brown a little bit there, and it's like, I don't know, I just don't get it.
Well,
and then he I don't know. Apparently, now it's coming out like it was all his plan all along. Like, it was his plan to do that all along.
Well, and where he ended up with, you know, the evil empire.
Don't say the evil empire.
Evil empire.
Tom Brady's a hunk, okay? Greatest quarterback
Tom
of all
Brady
time.
Is the greatest Tom quarterback Brady to ever sling a pigskin.
He is,
Tom
man.
Brady.
He is.
Tom Brady. But Belichick is like Darth Vader.
Well, yeah. I mean, no, he's the emperor.
Yeah. Well, no.
And Tom
Robert
is
Kraft
the,
would
Tom
be more
Vader
of the
okay,
emperor,
yeah.
Because he's like the...
Right.
And then...
Do they have massage parlors in outer space?
Oh, dear God.
I had to do it.
I know. It was there. It was good.
Yeah.
They do have massage
master
parlors.
No, I'm
in
saying
outer
Master
space.
Did
no.
it.
See, I think that's funny. That's like, it's like gone now.
Yeah.
You don't hear about it.
His name
anyway,
is just Master?
His actual name is Master.
Like, it's like, is it Master Smith? Master P?
No, his first name is Master. He used to
Master
be
Bader.
He did stuff for Bleacher Report and Washington Post and the
he has no other name. His name is just Master.
His it's first like literally so he was on my Israel trip and in the book there's like an interesting fact about you and his interesting fact was my name is actually Master.
His family has no surname. They just name their kids like one word.
No, I mean he has a last name, but and his name is Master.
Master and his last name is Bader.
I just say Master Tess. His
that'd
last
be,
name is hard
that'd
to
be
say.
Really
weird. Testophiles. Master Testophiles.
Testafari.
Why would a parents name their child Master?
And then he's a cool dude.
And their kid when there's a kid are like, "Hey, Master, come here." I'm like, "I don't have to come here. I'm your Master."
Yeah. There's a lot to unpack with that.
Different.
Like
he has a new show called Untold Stories where he like. It just hangs with a bunch of athletes and gets all the shit before it's broken.
Yeah.
The news.
But basically, I would imagine that that's just, I'm still, this name. Like,
Master.
He missed, he
you're
missed
jealous.
Something. No, like he missed something with naming his show. Like, well, isn't it, you know, like the Master Tapes, you know?
Master Debater.
Yeah.
Master Baker.
There's
should have a baking
a
show.
Yeah. You should have a baking
Master
show.
Master Baker.
So,
Master Baker.
In college, we had the fraternity league sports, and there was one person who wrote Master B on the back of their jersey, and they were the number 8.
Master Bates.
Master Bates.
I went to a school with a kid named Ricky Bates, and we had those senior shirts where you could put like your nickname on the back, and the school would not let him put Master on the back of his shirt.
So he couldn't be Master Bates.
Yeah, some smart decision by the school. I bet they're a good college, Ivy League.
Boring.
The servant waits while the master baits. Well, it's from Young Frankenstein, I believe. Yes. Wow.
I know old Frankenstein.
Yeah.
What
well,
happened?
I don't
today?
Know.
We went from talking about A. Brown to Master.
To the Pats.
Guy named Master.
On a plane. You know, thanks a lot.
I think he's living with Tom Brady.
He is?
I think so.
Maybe they have a bromance.
But see, that to me, like, that's why I think that this was a full-on, like, collusion type thing. Because he was trying to get his way out. And, like, he's doing the prima donna thing, but then he's going to a team where everyone who's been on that team has said it's a we mentality, it's not a me mentality.
I don't think he's going to like Belichick's way of...
I think they're going
to
shame
like,
him up.
They're going to be like, no social media, no this, no that.
I think... He wanted to go there because I think he wants a ring, and that is a place where he can go. So, like, I think he'll be fine, and he'll get a ring. It might be a year or two that he's there. It's a one-year deal. Boom. He gets a ring. He's gone. You
and
know?
He says, I'm retiring.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if he'll retire or go somewhere else,
I'm
but, I mean,
saying,
he's
like
there
half,
to get
like
rings.
Half the league.
Rings are what it's all about. Boom.
It's all people want nowadays.
It's all about rings. It wasn't about rings in the Loch Ness, though.
What is
do you remember a couple weeks ago or months ago we talked about the plesiosaur? We talked about them doing the DNA test in Loch Ness.
Dinosaur DNA.
They were scooping up the water to see what was in it.
I thought you were going to say the poop. They were scooping up the poop.
They were doing the poopa scoopa.
So they were scooping up water to see what was in the water.
Right, like the DNA that was in the water. Right.
What? How would you even be able to tell there's so many... Science. Animals, aren't there?
Well, that's what they were like. They were going through and like looking at all the different types of things, cross-referencing it against known DNA samples.
Right.
And?
Science.
Right.
No plesiosaurs, apparently.
Which is what they think Nessie is?
Well, they thought. Oh. And now it turns out it's just a bunch of eels.
That theory was out there, though. Yeah,
Nessie could just be a giant eel.
Have you taken a DNA test?
Nope. We've had this discussion. Don't trust it. Not going to do it.
You had your...
Wouldn't
you
be prudent.
Done it. You could have taken a song lyric there, but that was not why I said it. I have one sitting at my house.
DNA test?
An Ancestry.com one, and I've been scared to do it. I think I should just rip the Band-Aid off and do it.
How do you know that they're just not BSing you?
But I know some people who know where their family's from, and the DNA test pretty much exactly told them what they already knew. Mm. But for somebody like me that's just like, oh, you're a European mutt.
Yeah, I'd be curious to know what it would all be.
Yeah. But they tell you specifically where, like Ireland or Scotland or... I would be interested to know.
Scotland. Yeah. See, I don't want to know. I know kind of where I'm from, and I don't want to have them having my records on file anywhere.
You know they could get it.
Well, they've got it anywhere. They've already taken my blood.
They've probably stolen your cup at the coffee shop and done a little swab. All those people following you.
Yeah.
Oh, did you see where that Russian spy was extracted? Or the American spy in Russia was extracted?
How long ago was it?
I don't know. It was like recently. They just extracted.
He doesn't know. I'm just saying.
I don't know. He was a part of the extraction.
Know anything about it.
Who was? I wasn't.
It's like, I don't know what you're talking about.
You're a good actor.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Yeah. There was a Russian spy.
There was an American spy in Russia that was extracted because they feared for his life. Yeah.
No way.
They thought his safety had been compromised.
Oh, my God.
But it said that he was like in Putin's inner circle, like close enough that he could take. Are you f-ing with me? He could take photos of like the papers on Putin's desk.
No, I haven't heard anything about that. I'm sure whatever was on those documents were.
Did you say he was taking photos under Putin's desk?
No, of
D-pics.
It's a Putin upskirt.
How funny would it be if he had like just like Putin's little doodles? Do you think Putin calls his? What do you think Putin calls his penis?
Vlad the Impaler.
That was a pretty good one. I'm going to give you that one.
Speaking of vampires.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
I had something on my mind, but I forgot all about it because we got talking about.
I think I cussed more than just that once, by the way.
And it's been a long time. That's a Green Day lyric. Yeah, you won. I cussed twice. You dropped another F-bomb?
Yeah.
Mother cuss bucket.
Like, it was like in the last 10 minutes, I think.
Okay. So in the last 10 minutes.
Why is it hot in here?
It is. I'm going to take off all my clothes.
I am. Yeah. So I'm going to take my clothes off. Nelly was in Indy. I know Nelly doesn't sing that song.
Nelly was in the right genre.
Yeah, he was doing a concert Saturday night.
Did you go?
That is Nelly.
No. No, I don't think. I thought that was 50
hot
Cent.
Hot in here is Nelly.
I thought it was 50 Cent.
No. Hot in her is Nelly. Yeah.
You sure?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If I would have known that, I probably went to the concert Saturday night just to hear her play Hot.
Nelly had like Country Grammar.
All the Country Grammar songs are so good.
Over and Over in My Head with Tim McGraw. 2004 throwback right there.
That's all in my head. Florida Georgia Line were playing, and I think some other one.
They probably did Over and Over because that's, you know, like Tim McGraw's like.
Over and Over again.
Yeah. Yeah. Can't keep picturing you with him.
Terrible.
Yeah. Yeah, and it hurts so bad.
He sang a remix version of the song.
He did. Yeah. Because you know what? He's a sellout. He sang at the halftime show for the Panthers last year.
Yeah.
Like towards the end of the season, and was like, hell yeah, it's Nelly singing like all of these good songs. And then he sang one of those. Like he did Country Grammar. He did Hot in Here. He did.
So hot and
going down, baby. O Street in the Range Rover.
That's a good one.
Baby.
Cock ready to let it go. Yeah, shimmy, shimmy, cocoa pop.
Is that the one that he mentions? JG. No. What's the one that he mentions? Jeff Gordon.
Did I?
In the Navigation. Black SS.
That was when rap was good.
Yeah.
Got these boys now can't rap. Rap about drugs. Women.
Chance the Rapper is the slowest rapper. I don't know why people think he's so talented.
I don't listen to rap.
Is he slower than Mace?
Mace was a different kind of slow.
What do you mean he's slow?
Like he doesn't
cadence.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, I don't think he's talented in...
people love Chance. I think he speaks good words. Yeah. You know, I don't listen to him, but I speaks good words.
There's the style, like the cadence of a lot of the stuff now is that... And I think Snoop had a thing about it. It's like that...
He made fun of him.
It's like, that's not really... Like,
yeah.
Give me something... Like Kendrick. I'm a big fan of Kendrick.
Yeah.
Kendrick Lamar.
I like fast rappers.
Like an outcast, Luda. I was going Luda.
Twista. Like Busta Rhymes. Busta. Twista and Luda and Busta. All the us.
What about Exhibit?
Oh, I like Exhibit.
Yeah.
I like Exhibit.
Yeah. I like Exhibit.
X to the Izzo.
Oh ODB. My gosh.
ODB.
I just got you mean like Big the Baby most Jesus? Stereotypical when you said, oh, I like Exhibit.
I like Exhibit.
You're a blonde white girl.
She was a big fan of Pimp My Ride.
I love Exhibit. Like the best rapper ever. Loved his show too. Pimp My Ride.
West Coast Customs.
I actually never watched his show.
They put a lot of junk in my trunk.
Wow. I could see somebody saying that though.
Yeah. I mean, they always put stuff in the trunk. They do like video games and stuff in the back.
We like to fish, so we put in a big ass aquarium in his trunk.
My man, you're going to get an aquarium. That's more, Firefest.
You were doing
DMX.
You were doing DMX.
You gotta like bark.
That dude needs now like a Rick permanent Ross. Lozenge.
Now do Rick Ross.
Have you seen? What is it? Hang on. I can do Rick Ross. What's it? It's Top Five with Chris Rock, where like he gets arrested and he goes to jail and DMX is in jail and
he's singing where like DMX has been.
No, he's like singing Fiddler on the Roof. Baba. DMX.
Party up! Let me tell you though. We'll get you going.
Oh my God.
What?
He hasn't put anything out in a while. In fact, he came on the radio, this was a few months ago, and I said, RIP, and Joey looked at me like, what? DMX is not dead? And I realized he wasn't dead, and I said, well, he might as well be because
he hasn't made
anything in a while.
He had a great, he had one song I really liked. Stop.
Drop.
Shut him down.
Shut him down. Let him up shop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Oh.
That's the Rough Riders role.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you a Rough Riders fan?
You can't stop, drop, and open up shop by yourself.
No, you can't.
Need some help.
Well, see, we used to do that at West Charlotte. In my high school, we do stop, drop, shut him down, open up shop. No, that's the West Charlotte role. So, yeah,
this sounds like...
We co-opted the lyric.
Yeah, like that cheerleader movie.
Yes. Oh, it was already Ben Broughton.
Ryan the Closet, bring it on, fan.
I have two sisters.
This is a cheer.
It's true.
Tatership.
Cheerocracy.
Cheerocracy. Yeah. Yeah. And I am the cheer tater.
Yeah.
And I make the cheer decisions around here.
Well, I'm getting at. Rappers were a lot better back in the day.
That is true.
Yeah,
I think.
ODB. I'm a big fan.
I love some
the
ODB.
The Wu-Tang Clan, the RZA, the GZA, yeah. Inspecta Deck, Ghostface Killa.
Yeah.
There were a lot of...
if you watch the history of hip-hop that's on the Netflix...
Oh.
There's a good... It's like a... or the evolution of hip-hop. It's on Netflix. It's a series about the birth and
the growth of... I haven't fired up the Netflix recently.
Like, when they're talking about like the early DJs that were sitting there with the records and figuring out, all right, so this is the beat that I like. How do I get that break beat? I know I'm on market here on this record and like do all this stuff to make sure that... Mm-hmm. When they spun it around, they'd get it at the right spot and just get it to loop.
Like
it,
all the technical.
And now you just drag and drop stuff in a computer and you do it.
And press a button.
Yeah.
And they were figuring it out on the fly. Like the birth of rap is just one of the, like that is a true art form that when it first came out, it was like, this is amazing. Like the people that came up with this were geniuses. Yeah.
And now they just use the same like phrase over and over again in a song.
Over and over again.
Da, 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 da. But
Nelly was warning us about this shit back in the day.
Who? Mm-hmm. What?
Nelly.
Oh.
Over and over again. That's all they sing.
X gonna give it to you.
And I don't like them making birds. Like, a lot of them have their like sounds they make sounds. Nowadays. I don't like it.
Birdman? I actually do like Birdman.
Birdman was fine. Okay?
Birdman was good.
No, what was the dude saying? The panda.
The game?
Panda,
I liked the
panda
game.
Song.
Panda, oh, panda.
Like a bird. He does like a bird noise all the time. I don't like it.
Hannah Montana?
Yeah, Hannah Montana.
Hannah Montana.
I like that show.
I was just saying Hannah Montana.
I know
Montana.
It's a song, yeah. But I like that show.
It was a good show.
Miley
I never
Cyrus
watched
is
it,
getting good looking again.
Is she?
You notice
well,
that?
She's single now. That's and she's making out with girls. So I imagine.
So you're
that influences your
for Jonathan Merriman because he's got long hair. Sorry, I was making a long hair joke about Jonathan Merriman.
Oh,
she's making out with the girls.
Oh,
he's got long
there was
hair.
A there were a lot of dots to connect there. That
reach.
Was a little bit of a
I'm
reach.
I'm sorry, you know, not
he's
all
gone,
of them are winners.
Yeah. He's gone
you know?
Full blown long hair.
He has.
He has gotten very long hair,
long flowing locks. Some would say he looks a little bit like Bigfoot because he's kind of a hairy man.
Yeah, maybe.
Like he was probably hiding out in the woods in McDowell County, North Carolina.
Where is McDowell County?
Was there
County?
Bigfoot?
Yeah, there were three.
Three of them.
Three big feet.
No way.
See, that's it. Says there were three Bigfoots.
No,
like, would you
wouldn't
call
it be
them,
big feet?
But like, if Bigfoot is an animal, would
you
call
say
it
Bigfoots? It just sounds
Bigfoots
terrible.
Or big feets. There are three
you,
big
I
feets.
I don't think there's. I don't
wouldn't
know.
Wouldn't you say big feet with no S? I saw
big feet. Big
like,
feet.
What's
there
the plural of Bigfoot? What big is foots. The plural of Bigfoot?
I think the
Bigfoot.
Plural of foot is feet. So
I feel like WCNC who reported this originally.
Yeah,
they had to go off of like the AP style guide or something, some sort of style guide. So they probably had to look up what
well,
is
Bigfoot's
the plural
a name.
Of Bigfoot. Yeah.
So not like a.
Yeah.
Thing.
It's not just like a Bigfoot.
Yeah.
Is out in the.
So it's probably why they chose to do an S instead Bigfoot. Of make it feet.
Yeah. But yeah, guy said he saw him. Took about 10 minutes worth of video. There's.
Did they show the video?
They showed a snippet of it on WCNC, and it also made some other. National news outlets, but apparently McDowell County, Marion, North Carolina. It's just east or west of Morganton.
Hickory.
Yeah, Hickory.
Hickory.
If you go up, if you're heading
they
40,
make that furniture.
It's between Morganton and Asheville on I-40, right there before you get to Black Mountain.
I love Asheville.
Yeah, but that whole area.
That's where the
big
live.
Foot country. Yeah.
Mm.
Probably out where you live too, Ryan.
You've got some big feet out
running
there.
Around.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'd be scared if I lived at your house by myself.
Him and the Russian spies are.
There might be a couple of big fucks.
Do you ever get scared at your house at night watching scary movies by yourself?
Really.
Have you seen It, by the way?
I
It
did.
2?
I saw It Chapter 2 last Thursday.
How was it?
I'm pretty
not,
good.
Not going to see it. I heard it was funny. I heard they.
There was a lot of funny parts in it.
Really?
There was a lot of parts I was like, that was pretty funny. I laughed out loud. Bill Hader in it. Is hilarious.
There's a lot of big stars in it. The Old Spice guy is in it.
Yeah, Isaiah Mustafa.
Yeah.
He's in it. The redhead.
Jessica Chastain.
She's
so hot
that's
in Molly's
her.
Game.
Yes. Please marry me. They're great in it. And there's a couple other good actors in it. But
was it scarier than the first one?
It wasn't really scary. There were a couple like, oh shit moments. Like that was pretty weird. That was kind of scary, but it was good. I mean, it's 3 hours long.
What?
Jesus, Mary and Joseph.
Yeah.
For a horror film,
but it's like
long.
It's a good like story arc movie.
Mm-hmm.
Like they combine a good bit from like the first and the second one. I thought it was pretty good. I enjoyed it.
Interesting.
So, and Bill Skarsgård is just good as Pennywise in It.
Ew.
No, Tim Curry though.
He's pretty good. I think he's better.
I mean, I like Tim Curry. Oh. Tim Curry, like
I like Tim Curry, but I watched the old It movies, and it's just like silly to me.
Oh well, a lot of old scary movies are kind of
or silly.
Silly.
Yeah, but that was the norm back then, right? I mean, everyone thought those were terrifying.
I'm a big fan of Tim Curry in Clue.
Mm-hmm.
It's a great movie.
Game?
No, the movie.
Like
Clue.
But it's about the movie about the game.
Yeah, Colonel Mustard and the conservatory with
it's
the lead pipe.
It's been a long time since I've seen that.
That is probably one of the best movies, comedies out there.
Yeah,
I think my favorite scene in that there's a singing telegram lady that comes up. She, I am your singing
you
telegram.
You just want to sing today.
Well, and then as soon as she says that, like
she gets
shot. Yeah, I laughed.
I wish I had.
I thought that was funny. I'm morbid.
You are morbid.
Yeah.
When does that prequel to The Shining come out with Ewan McGregor?
It's not a prequel.
Or whatever. It flashback a sequel but then they do flashbacks.
Yeah. He's a
cuz he's a kid.
Yeah, he's the kid.
Red Rum.
Yeah.
Red Rum.
the kid that plays the kid is a family friend. Plays little Danny.
Is it Master?
No, it's not Master.
Master
but
played Danny.
I
Master
would be
Danny.
Terrified to be a child actor in a scary movie.
Yeah.
Is what I was getting at.
Scar you.
Like, I think it would scar you.
Would it, though? Because
yes.
I feel like on those sets,
depends.
Like, are those sets actually scary, or is, like, you know, because there's the stuff you see on Game of Thrones where the Night King and, like, you know, Arya and the kid, like, all, like, they knew him and, like, he was, like, cool guy hanging out on set. Yeah. Like,
I feel like, you know, it's a job.
Yeah.
But even, like, as a kid,
or
a
what
young
about
kid,
like sketchy, like, not sketchy, but like risque movie. So that movie Good Boys, have you seen the previews for it? And those kids are so young with that material. Okay. I just wonder.
Yeah, but how old are they? What, 13?
They're talking about that anyway.
Yeah. Like, I mean, when'd you start cussing?
I don't know. Probably, yeah, probably around that age.
Six. I was hoping you would say F if I know.
Like, yeah. Rhino.
No, guys.
What do you get when you cross an elephant and a rhinoceros?
I think, like, the girl from Poltergeist wasn't there.
Elif Rhino.
Girl from Poltergeist, yeah, she's...
Summer Blair?
I would actually...
Summer Blair? No, that was...
I actually heard, like, that screwed her up.
Yeah, it screwed her up.
Not Selma Blair. Was it Selma?
Selma Blair is. No. She has MS.
No, but it was a Blair, wasn't it?
Selma.
The Blair Witch Project.
No, it was in The Exorcist.
I'm just saying, if I was a child actor in a scary movie, I think I would be scarred for life.
I think it depends on the movie. And
although The Shining is more like a thriller.
Yeah, it's not like a scary movie.
But, like, if you
Linda
were
Blair.
In
Linda Blair.
Linda Blair. Poltergeist.
Poltergeist. Yeah.
Poltergeist.
Poltergeist.
You have to say it with a Russian accent.
Poltergeist.
Poltergeist.
This house is clear.
That's coming out. What other scary movies are coming out?
Scary movies coming out.
I don't know.
Have you seen Mindhunter?
They made an Exorcist 2 in 1977. Does anyone know this?
Yes.
I'm Linda terrified Blair? Of the first.
Annabelle Comes Home.
Exorcist 2, The Heretic.
Speaking of movies that they
Heretic?
Have,
Heretic.
They've redone or are currently redoing.
Yeah.
Face Off.
Face.
I hope they cast Nick Cage again.
Bitcha.
And John Travolta. Both of them.
How do
you redo
do
that? Anyway. I'm sick of these reboots.
It's like I saw there's a 2019 Pet Sematary. Like, that's what made me think of that.
Yeah.
It's like, why are you redoing Pet Sematary? Why are you going to redo?
I feel like that would screw a kid up.
Oh, yeah.
Pet Sematary?
Yeah. Here's
if
Fluffy.
I guess it's like the money outweighs. If you're a parent, would you let your kid be in one of these scary movies?
Yes.
Yes.
And I'm going to put in the contract, you will take care of therapy for the rest of this kid's life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that should be worked into the...
should be in the contract.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah. And there should be a therapist on site to help... these kids. Sorry, there is a Tyrannosaurus Rex over there that's just staring at me this whole show.
Okay.
But I can't tell which, like...
It says it's a Godzilla.
Dougzilla.
But it's a... So it's a Godzilla beast, not a T-Rex. Okay. Squirrel.
I just... It's been staring at me. So.
Back to Face Off.
Yeah. Face Off.
Face.
Nick Cage.
I'm going to be honest with you. I never saw Face Off.
Oh. What?
I'm going to scoop closer. I'm guessing. To I'm Chuck and farther away from you. I am... offended.
Homework, Ryan.
Never saw it.
That's what you can do on your flight.
Yeah.
Right. Actually,
it is, and I saw an article really about this. Like, somebody said it's like a fine wine.
It actually
and I'm drunk on it.
Yeah, was it like time?
Yeah.
Maybe my favorite Nick Cage movie.
Really? Better than National Treasure.
And National Treasure is really
Raising
good.
Arizona?
National Treasure.
Better than Raising Arizona?
Better than Ghost Rider.
Yes.
Better
yes.
than Gone in 60 Seconds.
Yes.
Okay, maybe it's my favorite John Travolta movie.
Yes.
My favorite Nick Cage movie.
Okay, Grease.
Grease is the word. Is
yeah.
Pulp Fiction.
Pulp Fiction.
Face Off is so good.
Face Off is good. Face Off is.
I don't. Yeah. I'm guessing Travolta and Nick Cage swap faces in this.
Yes.
But it's so good. They play each other and they do it so well. Like they
Nick
play,
Cage plays
like,
Travolta.
Like
Travolta plays Nick Cage.
Like they embody the physicalities of each other.
You look back at their history.
It's so good.
This movie probably messed them up. That's how they started going downhill.
Yeah. No, I mean,
it was Face
Off.
1997. It's got a 92 on Rotten Tomatoes.
Dude.
It is 7.3
out of 10 on IMDb and then an 82% on Metacritic.
It's been a while since I've seen it. I will watch that movie anytime it comes on.
You know how Steve Letart went and watched Days of Thunder because
I was like, where is this?
Dale was like, oh, you never seen Days of Thunder? You working in the NASCARs?
Yeah.
This is not quite the same. But
it's better.
It is an iconic movie
I'll watch it. Do you think Face Off's way more iconic than Days of Thunder? Nationally.
In what sense?
And the American viewing eyes.
I think, that's
if you
hard.
Say, if you tough. Say, if I'm, you go up to a random person, you say Face Off or Days of Thunder.
I'm so cultured to think Days of Thunder is prominent because I work in racing, so I don't know.
Like, does it resonate outside of
Who was I just talking to that whose girlfriend is like, oh, that Thunder movie. The girlfriend didn't know anything about Days of Thunder, and every time it comes on, she knows he likes it, and she's like, that movie about the Thunder is on. What are you looking up?
Based off of Rotten Tomatoes, Face Off, 20 times better. Rotten Tomatoes gives Days of Thunder a 39%.
What?
Wow.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like Face Off is almost certified fresh.
Yeah. I mean, if it's a 80 what?
89?
Wow. That's certified fresh. Yeah. I'll eat that tomato all day long.
I will. Have some of that. No, 92. It is certified fresh. Oh, it's 92.
That's a B plus. I wonder if they did a sequel to Days of Thunder like they're doing for Top Gun, if it would help.
Oh, we, talked you, we talked about it.
Bless you. We talked about it. Doing a sequel.
Did I dream that they're doing that?
If it would help. Bless you. If it help the prominence of Days of Thunder. No. Like, would the Rotten Tomatoes score go up? Do those scores fluctuate?
They can.
Aren't they user-driven?
There is a lot of user-driven stuff, so like if you sort of...
Even with old movies like that?
It's like crowdsourcing kind of like
people can
ways.
Go back in and review and say, oh, this is better.
Face Off is so good. Yeah, I'm really upset about the reboot.
So you got to tell me the premise, okay? Don't spoil the movie, but like how did these guys switch places?
So it's John Travolta, FBI agent.
Okay.
Or is it Nick Cage, FBI agent?
See, it gets tricky because they switch and you don't know.
You
and
got
you're like, what's
criminal,
happening?
FBI agent.
Yeah.
One of them, okay.
They switch.
They switch.
And they take over each other's lives.
Don't tell me how they switch.
I think the FBI agent is going undercover.
Yeah, and they have him. Remember, they have
There's a whole
Nick Cage. Yeah.
It's a whole.
And when he, when the monitor.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Yeah.
What?
Yeah. Face. You got to watch it.
I can tell. I could tell Kim is like probably the biggest fan of this movie.
It's so
She's
good.
She's getting so pumped up right now. For
it
this
came out during our formative years, though.
It was 90, it came out in 1997, which is a strong
Ryan
year.
Ryan was like four.
That was like, getting ready to head into high school?
It was like middle school.
Into middle school.
So did they say Face Off in the movie?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, so they named the title of the movie in the movie.
You have to name the title in every movie.
Face Off. I'm going to be saying that all day, and I'm not going to know what the premise
is. Well, once you see it, you're going to be doing it.
Yeah. Bitch.
You have to watch it before next week, promise.
Does he say, is that bitch in line from Face Off? Or what movie is that where Nick Cage, you know, that thing I have going, bitch.
It might be.
Yeah, like that's one of my favorite Nick Cage-isms.
I love crazy Nick Cage too. So I think if this movie's anything like you think it is, or you're telling me, I hope it's worth it.
I think it is. We might be building it up.
I might go home and watch it tonight. I hope it's on Netflix.
So Face Off to you, like how important it was to your guys. Would you say that's one of the most important movies of your childhood?
No,
it's just a great movie. Yeah.
It's like a cult classic-ish. Right. Like, I don't know if it was a blockbuster, but I just remember it coming out. I think I saw it in the theater, actually.
Huh. So to me, one of those movies that is like Hocus Pocus.
Oh, Hocus Pocus is good.
I love that. That was like a childhood
like
movie on like all the time.
It's also a John Woo film.
Ooh.
So you know it's got the
mind blowing
explosion stuff. It's like when you add Michael Bay or John Woo, you're gonna get spectacular
explosions.
Yeah. We're gonna do
and the wife.
Yeah.
The whole
with the thing and the crazy.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
One of the guy, the criminal, go home and bang the FBI agent's wife. I get
there's
it.
Like a, there's like, a, there's
you
like a second
you
thing.
You get my child to we call don't, you. You call. Call
damn it.
Daddy.
We don't
want to turn the page.
Well, I don't want to ruin the twist of it, of the movie. Yeah.
I want to know the twist.
Cam Radio 12. That's the twist.
Cam Radio 12.
In God We Must.
Okay.
Cam Radio 12. Have time did we start this?
What is happening?
I think we're about out of time.
We have gone
Jane, get
all
me
over
off
the map.
This crazy thing.
Playoff media day.
Oh yes,
we're on the boulevard.
So, playoffs are
Friday the 13th and the full moon.
Yeah, Friday the 13th is coming up,
and it's a full moon or something.
Nice, cool.
And we got a truck race, right? Truck race.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All three series race this weekend.
All three series in action at Las Vegas Motor Speedway.
Is it a truck cutoff race?
I think it is. It's the finale.
Yep.
Before the playoffs. Like this regular season finale?
No. They're already in their playoffs.
Yeah.
It's regular season finale for Xfinity.
Xfinity. Is what
Xfinity.
I'm yes.
Yeah. Trucks. Truck. It's their first.
Trucks
round
is the first. Off. Yeah. Sorry. There's a lot. That's. I want all of the playoffs to start yeah. and end at the same time. It's the start the end for the trucks. Time. It's yeah. the end for the. Xfinity.
It's the end of the world as we know it.
Yeah. And it's the beginning for the. It's the end of the world. So many yeah. songs.
There's so much going on.
It's a good thing we're bad at singing or else we would get yeah. in trouble probably.
It just seems like we're so talking.
Bad. We are. We are. We are talking about
people. So burnouts on we'll the give boulevard.
Something to talk about.
We'll do burnouts on the boulevard on Thursday. So tomorrow.
Yes.
Were you just singing this?
Yeah.
Yeah. I caught the very end.
Talk about love. 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 Going to do anything special for your
My
burnout?
My voice is sore. It's been sore for a month and a half. This is not an acoustic environment for me. Am I going to do anything special like we yeah. did last year? I don't know. I haven't thought of anything yet.
I'm surprised they're still doing it. There. Yeah,
me too.
What day is that? What
Thursday.
Day?
Tomorrow.
I'm telling you. Just
by the time this podcast comes out,
it'll be like, happening.
It will happen.
As
tomorrow.
You're listening to this podcast, you might be watching the Burnouts on the Boulevard on NBC.
Yeah,
right. So, on NBC.
How we'll do you? That. Yeah. How do you feel about
Ghost riding that whip?
I don't think that's right.
They would not. I don't think they would let you. No. I feel like the
hand slaps.
I feel like the
they got. Remember, they used to get mad at Larson for taking the wheel off. The
I feel like that's. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, not good. No, and especially in that environment where there's people,
yeah,
like don't ghost ride.
That's just not safe.
Like ghost riding the whip, though, like you're not like going fast. You're just letting it coast. So you could just
still.
That's what you should do instead of a burnout. Just ghost ride it and let it just like
cars
ghost.
Don't go straight though.
Huh? I know they
they go left.
Even these,
go left.
Even the show car, like the ones that you do, yeah. Like they're
a little bit left. They're not like road course cars set, to where they're like. Road course cars will go straight,
yeah,
because they have equal camber both ends. Yeah. But these are like
you don't have a special setup for these cars for burnouts. It's
burning down.
Here's an old beater right here.
What's the goal for the burnout for you?
The goal?
Yeah,
I don't know. Like last year was cool when Chase and I went nose to nose.
Went nose. That was actually really cool.
I thought that was unique.
Tip to tip.
We tipped it.
Yeah,
and the goal. I don't know. I don't know what to do this year. Maybe we'll go ass to ass this year.
Has anybody done different color smoke?
Face down.
Oh, that'd be cool.
You could do that.
Yeah, get some special tires.
Maybe like red or something, like red smoke. Yeah,
it's a little too late though.
Yeah.
You need to order some tires. I think they make tires that do that, but.
Do a gender reveal. Like,
oh,
in such time as you ever have a child. Wait
That's
till
what
the burnout.
Did.
No, but during,
oh,
the,
during
burnout
the burnout
on
the boulevard.
Boulevard.
Or, and don't tell anybody you have a kid on the way, and they're just like, why is he blowing red, blue smoke?
I'm having a baby. Yeah. Woo!
Why is he so excited?
Yeah.
I don't know. We'll figure it out.
Yeah.
You got anybody riding with you in your car? Or is it just.
I have no idea.
Either you'll find out.
They don't tell us anything.
Does the car get smoky?
A little bit. Yeah. A little bit.
Smoke gets in your eyes.
Out. Yeah.
Smoke on the water.
I can't help it. They're just
at the.
They just keep happening.
Tip of your
tongue.
Tip of your tongue, and we keep setting them up for it.
The tip of your tongue.
Oh my god!
Are you staying in Indiana tonight? Or are you flying to Vegas from Indiana?
Staying in Indiana tonight.
Not Louisiana. What's happening right now?
He's opening because it's probably
he's ready to go.
No, I'm trying to mask the smell of what just happened.
Oh no! We need to go. Oh. We need to go now. There's the music.
I'm guarding Chuck and I. Oh, this one's not even open.
Hang on. I got a new computer and I don't know how it works.
Yeah.
It's got one of the slide bars that's like digital touch stuff.
I don't
so
like
I don't,
it.
Digital.
Oh, your ports are gone too?
Yeah. I lost my ports. I got a dock with a dongle.
Oh, a dongle.
Yeah.
Dingle dangle.
Dangle or dangle with your dongle. A little tiptoe through the tulips.
Tippity tappity.
Rest in peace, Tiny Tim. Gone too soon.
200 years later. Playoffs this weekend. Kicking off the first round.
Trucks on Fox.
The Cup Series.
I like how you said Trucks on Fox.
But they are. I mean, they're on the Fox family
of
networks.
That's going to make me sneeze. All those bottles open, it just hit
your
my
eyes
nose.
Are watering. You're like,
I'm trying to hold it in.
Remember, there's a Pit Boss Pyramid.
Pit Boss Pyramid. Like Pit Boss.
I want to bowl through it. I really want to punch straight through, but I want them to like knock over and spill.
Got to.
And I don't want them to hurt you.
Don't do it just yet.
Yeah.
Oh! Hey!
Hey! That was actually really fun.
Got some comments about our grilling episode.
And?
Did people give us crap for it?
No.
the general consensus was it was weird and awesome because it was weird.
Because we're weird?
Yeah.
It was a little weird.
Awkward.
I got a lot of props on my catch.
Yeah?
My beer
yeah.
catch, man.
Yeah, it was good.
Snag.
Yeah.
Couple, a lot. Well, some of my crew guys were like,
threw a good. Rocket at you.
Threw like a 97-mile-an-hour fastball.
Threw that high stinking Limburger.
Yeah.
Threw the hot cheese.
Boy, I didn't, the Italian sausage was the most delicious. Because
the song's about to end.
Yeah.
Kim loves sausage.
I love sausage.
The ribs.
Adam's ribs.